Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about L-glutamine. L-glutamine, it's an amino acid. It's found in many different types of foods. Broths, for example, chicken or bone broth, you'll find it in. You'll find it in brassicas. You'll find it in fish. High-protein foods often contain lots of glutamine. Many bodybuilders, for example, or people into workouts, you know, into athletics, like glutamine because it definitely has a boosting effect on muscle growth, even skeletal muscle. Bone will benefit from glutamine. Brain function will benefit from glutamine because of the glutamine-glutamate cycle on how that works. So how much do you need and why is it good? And, well, the small bowel in particular, or many cells lining the small bowel, but other parts of the digestive tract benefit from glutamine because it's one of the primary fuels for enterocytes or cells that line the gut. Some studies I've seen have shown that glutamine can dramatically increase secretory IgA. So your immune system can really improve in the gut with L-glutamine. But I've also had many people who've aggravated very badly by taking L-glutamine. I did a video on L-glutamine, I think it may have been 1 or 2 years ago. You can look it up in one of my playlists. And if you look at the comments, several people comment on how bad they felt after taking L-glutamine. So don't just jump straight into the water. Put your big toe in first, okay? So if you're going to take glutamine and you've got an upset stomach and you've got leaky gut and irritable bowel and maybe candida or problems or issues like that, don't just immediately jump in after looking on Google and take, you know, several grams a day or megadose on it because you could get very, very sick. As per usual, start with small doses and take it from there. I prefer glutamine to be taken in or around food, protein foods. It works better, I believe, than on empty stomach. Average dose for many people is, you know, anywhere between 500 up to 2000 milligrams per day. Some websites you look at can tell you to megadose from 30 grams up to 80 grams per day, which is pretty dumb in my opinion. Megadosing on any supplement just doesn't make sense, regardless of what it is. You know, that's like, whew, flies. That's like telling someone to eat 20 avocados per day. You just don't megadose on anything. All common sense. Start small, build up, watch the bowel motions, use the eyeball test, look into the toilet and see what the stool's doing, and also the gut comfort based on the glutamine. When you introduce glutamine into your diet as a supplement, don't have 10 other things coming in all at the same time. Take glutamine, for example, at a rate of, say, 500 milligrams per day for several days, build up to 1,000, watch the stool, watch the gut symptoms. Watch the food sensitivities. If you start noticing improvements or changes, you may well be getting really good benefit from it. You could slowly step it up to 1 or 2,000 milligrams per day. As per usual, if something benefits you, take it. If it doesn't, get rid of the crap. You don't need it in your diet, okay? But for people doing a lot of athletic stuff, really pushing their body hard, eating a lot of food, they're definitely going to benefit from glutamine. Leaky gut, very much. In a lot of cases, I've seen significant improvement in leaky gut. But if leaky gut is associated with SIBO or candida or lots of parasites, you may not tolerate glutamine that well initially and may need to cleanse and eradicate the, you know, these imbalances from the gut before you benefit from L-glutamine. So try it out. Give me some feedback. Thanks for tuning in.